There's another series of airfoils developed by NACA that basically, if we look at the load on the airfoil, it was defined to give a uniform load from the leading edge to some point, we'll call it A, and then taper down to zero at the trailing edge. So this would be X over C equals 1. So this family of airfoils is defined by the Camber-Line XC over C equals CL design. Again, you have some design lift coefficient over 2 pi 1 plus A times 1 over 1 minus A. And I've got 1 half A minus X over C squared times the natural log of the absolute value of A minus X over C minus 1 half 1 minus X over C squared times the natural log of 1 minus X over C. And I'll go into a new line here, plus 1/4, 1 minus X over C squared, minus 1/4, A minus X over C squared, minus X over C times the natural log of X over C, minus G minus H times X over C, where G is equal to 1 over 1 minus A squared, 1 half natural log of A minus 1/4 plus 1/4, and H is equal to 1 minus A over 4, 2 natural log of 1 minus A minus 1 minus G. Okay, so this is a rather complicated Camber-Line definition, but it can be used to get an airfoil that will very nearly create a uniform pressure load from the leading edge to some point A. You can see these A's all throughout the equations here, and then taper down from that to zero at the trailing edge.